Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. As you can see, my hair is very fluffy, very undefined, a little matted. It's very old and very dry, and it is definitely time for wash day. So I like to start off my wash day by detangling my hair, and there's a list of things that I will need. You want to get a good watery cheap conditioner, oil of your choice. I prefer coconut oil. Some water to help loosen your hair and help you work through the tangles. Some hair ties to help me section my hair off and separate it. And some hair clips to also help me separate my hair. So as you guys know, if you've seen any of my natural hair videos, I always start my hair off by separating it. I've said it 100 times and I'll say it once again. I like to section my hair off as opposed to taking on my hair a whole head of hair. It's a lot easier. It makes for quick, organized work, and it allows me to get a chance to see really what I'm doing with my hair, and it ensures that each strand of hair is coated properly and that it's properly detangled. So I just layered on those products, and now I am separating a chunk of hair, clipping the rest out of the way, and simply finger detangling. I have not used a comb or a tool. Oh, there's a knot. I wanted you guys to see that. I do get a lot of knots near the end of my hair, and it's very, very important to work through them and take your time. But I was saying that I do not use a comb or any tools on my hair. I prefer to finger detangle. I've noticed since I've started finger detangling over the past few years that I get a lot less shed and breakage. So if you guys finger detangle, let me know if you've also noticed that. And if you guys use a tool, let me know if you prefer to use a tool as opposed to finger detangling, and let me know why in the comments down below. So there's a quick shot of how much shed hair I have. As you can see, it wasn't a lot, and I'm just going over my ends once again because they're a little bit puffier than I would like, and then I'm going on to my last twist in that section. I'm spraying more water as needed. If your hair gets a little dry, be sure to have the water near so that you can spritz it. It's best to detangle your hair on damp hair. Never ever detangle your hair when it's dry. But as you can see, I am working my way from the ends to the root, and then twisting that section right on up. So as you can see, my hair is completely detangled and twisted up. It's a lot more shiny. And now we're going to go into my shampoo or cleanse, and I like to use Mane & Tail. The next step is to deep condition. Right now, my deep conditioner of choice is the Shea Moisture Deep Treatment Restorative Mask. It's one of the first products that I used on my natural hair as I was transitioning, and I just decided to start going back to basics. So While my hair is already in the twist, it makes it a lot easier to wash and get to my scalp, as well as apply my deep conditioner as the last step. Your hair is already sectioned and it's already detangled, so my fingers just glide through my hair while applying that deep conditioner. But I'm still finger detangling to ensure that the conditioner gets on each strand and all of my hair is properly coated. After it's properly coated from ends to root, I will go ahead and twist it up and move on to the next twist. So again, here I am starting at the ends and working my way up to the roots, finger detangling once again to make sure that my hair is thoroughly detangled. And as I stated, it is pretty detangled, so I can go ahead and just glide my fingers through and glide the product through. And after I feel like the hair is properly coated and there are no more knots or no more tangles, then I will twist it back up and move on to the next section. And when my entire head is completely coated with the conditioner, I will let it sit and process under a shower cap for about 2 or 3 hours and rinse it out, and that is it. That is the end of wash day. Thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, stay tuned.